Hello, I'm Darren Crapo, and welcome to episode 78 of UFO Planet. We have some exciting videos to show you today, including a fascinating video shot over the Bronx, New York. All of that's going to get started right away, but first, check out some of the clips that you'll see on today's program. Well, we have to get started right away today. I have a lot of videos to show you. Some of them are a little bit lengthy. So we're going to get started right away by heading off to Edgewater, New Jersey in the United States of America for a night vision video that was shot by Aaron Roberts and his daughter Deshae on November 7th. Let's check out and see what Aaron and Deshae had to see.
Couple of lights.
That one,
I think it's the middle one, the more brighter one, right here in the middle. I think it's that one, but look, you can't even see like these other lights you've seen on this here. You don't see it up there.
Mm-hmm.
Right.
Wrong.
Exactly. Look. Look at that moving. Look at that moving. You see it moving?
Yeah. It's going so fast?
Yeah, exactly.
What is that?
I don't know. look, you see it moving?
Uh-huh. It zoomed across.
Right. I'm following it. You see it? Look, you see what it's doing?
You see it? Where'd it go?
It's right
That's not
there.
The same thing.
It is.
Oh, it is.
Look, you see it flashing up top?
Yeah, that's it.
Mm-hmm. Where? It just saw that little blinking light all the way up there. Zoom out, this is the trees on my block. Now we're gonna go back to the sky. See, it's brighter on the camera than what we can see, but we can see that it's bright up there, and it's just stationary.
What is that?
That's just it trying to focus. Look at it blinking on the camera. You saw it was blinking?
Yeah.
So when you could do, get a nice little zoom up. I'm about to say, what the hell was that?
Interesting video there, shot over Edgewater, New Jersey. Thank you so much for sending that in, Aaron. And it sounds to me like you're making yourself a daughter there that is going to be into UFOs just like you. Fascinating. Good going there. Next, we're going to take a look at a video that was shot in Serbia. They built a new bridge in Belgrade called the Ada Bridge. And on June 17th of this year, there was a video captured of an object that seemed to be checking out the bridge. You can see two lights in the middle of your screen there. The larger of the two lights is actually just that, a light on the bridge. It's the smaller of the two objects on the left-hand side that we're looking at here, currently in digital zoom. Well, we were in digital zoom. June 17th. not a lot of movement exactly in this object here, but it does make some moves a little bit later. Very interesting. Maybe they're checking out to see how they build bridges here on Earth. Good job of shooting this MORAT. Appreciate your participation in UFO Planet. There we see a good picture of the light on top of the bridge there now. And this object is now moving away. So I think we can rule out satellites in the ISS because it was stationary there for quite a while. And now it's moving, so that's a good indication that we're not looking at a satellite or the ISS. Here we are in digital zoom now. Some sort of light orb over Belgrade, Serbia. Very interesting. Belgrade, Serbia, checking out the new Ada Bridge over there. Now we're going to go to a video that was shot on November 13th. Actually, it was redone on November 13th. This is a video from a little bit ago. And, well, it's titled, "The Moon is Not What You Think." Very interesting. When I saw this, I had heard about things about people believing that the moon didn't exist, that it's actually a hologram, or that there is a hologram being broadcast over the moon to cover up the activity on the moon. Not sure what to believe, but here's what Crow777 has to say. And make sure you jot down his YouTube channel so you can go check out some of his other videos he has there too. Here we go with Moon Hologram.
Second, let me get the clip started here. So I'm filming one night looking for objects. I pan my camera down and the wave starts, this hologram wave. I don't notice it. And then it catches up to the camera and I do notice it. I glance at the moon, but when you're staring at things, you know, you don't know whether it's your eyes or what. And then I notice a second wave coming. And at this point, I'm thinking it's my camera. I look up at the moon again and, you know, I just don't know what to think. I save the clip out, I don't delete it, I almost did, and I look at it for quite some time, weeks maybe, looking it over and over, and I'm realizing that, you know, this is not the way a digital camera malfunctions. This is an organic line, no pixelation, no shredding of the signal. And it finally dawns on me that the pan of the camera proves it. When I pan down, and I usually don't shoot this way, I usually stay centered, almost always stay centered, trying to increase my odds of catching something unusual. But when I pan down, the wave starts, and I pan in front of the wave, which catches up to the camera, and that is the proof in the pudding. You'll notice a couple things. The wave looks like it bulges in the center, as if it's going down. If you stop the frame and measure it, you'll see that the sides are lower than the center, so there's kind of a bulge, and it's also tilted a little bit, and it mirrors the tilt of the poles of the moon. I haven't measured it exactly, but visually you can tell. I would urge people to go look at Jive Bop and Grid Keeper. Grid Keeper catches structures, and Jive Bop has done some incredible work with incredible setup, and he claims you can see through the floor of the mare or the mare, the seas on the moon, and you can see structure and stuff under there. By the way, if I don't comment back, I apologize. I'm not going to use Google Plus. I'm boycotting it. I have another video on this. I have a degree in internet technology, and I tell you a few reasons why it's bad. Anyhow, moving on. After I posted this video and one other called Mars is No Longer Red, where I assert ISON may have electrically interacted with the planet, my UK traffic jumped, as did my New Zealand traffic, at which point I'm contacted by a astrophotographer for the country, I guess, the director for the country's astrophotography of comets and asteroids. And he tells me all the things I'm doing wrong and why I'm not scientific, and I am an amateur, but he won't provide me the images of Mars I'm asking for. And I noticed this clip also gets a ton of traffic from the UK, and none of my other stuff did before this. You know, it's, I guess it's not proof positive, but to me it's a note of interest. Now, a lot of people out there are saying the moon's not there, that it's just a projected hologram. I observe the moon straight for a year every month to catch all these objects that are shot and posted on my YouTube channel. I can tell you I believe the moon is there, and I believe that they cover it with a hologram so that we can't see what's going on the face of the moon, because we have good enough equipment to see these things now. So what I did is I bought a cheap light spectrum tool and a prism, and I observed daylight, I observed false light, man-made light, light bulbs and things like that, and then I shot through my telescope and just off a full moon the spectrum of the moon with a prism and the light spectrum tool. And it's not 100% scientific, but I can tell you that it's damn close to sunlight. So if the light I collected is off a hologram, it's a damn good one. Again, my guess is that when the moon's in like quarter phases or slivers or other things, you're actually looking at the moon. I think when it becomes, starts to get full or well lit on the face, they cover it with a hologram so that we can't see what they're doing under there. It's not what you think it is, I can tell you that. I've observed other people's video work and my own intuition, having stared at the moon for a year, I can tell you it's not just a rock in space. There's a lot going on up there, and I hope that a lot of people can see this clip, because this is the real deal, as are all the clips that I have on my YouTube channel. There is no manipulation. There, you know, if something's color corrected, I make it obvious, but there's no animation going on. These are all 100% real observation clips. Anyhow, I want to thank again the Jungle Surfer for sharing this out with the community, and giving me the narration request, and you guys all be safe.
Well, that was very interesting, and if any of you have any similar footage, I would also like to see that as well. I've never seen anything like that. Not sure I believe that the moon doesn't exist and there's a hologram there, but I know there are a lot of people out there who subscribe to that theory. I'm sure this will generate a lot of comments, and here's the comments that you had to say on episode 77 of UFO Planet. Well, thank you for coming back, and I just want to say thank you to everyone for the fantastic comments being made on the YouTube channel. I sat down one evening this week to read them, and I was editing the comments for this program that you just viewed, and I kind of got lost in reading the comments and forgot what I was doing because I was too interested in the comments. It's nice to see such long, detailed explanations, descriptions, things like that. That's absolutely fascinating. I also just want to make a comment on the recent changes at YouTube. As many of you know, now that you need to have a Google Plus account to post comments on YouTube, and I read an article this week from YouTube that explains why they have done this, and that's to finally clean up the comment section that a lot of people make really nasty comments on YouTube hiding behind a nickname. And I guess the people at Google feel that there'll be a lot less comments made like that if you have to put your real name and face to it. So for that alone, I think it's a great idea. Unfortunate that we have a lot of people out there that force changes like this upon all of us because of their misuse of technology. Well, now we're going to head over to Miami, Florida. This is a video that was shot recently, November 19th, early in the morning, by Jeremy Thomas. Let's see what Jeremy had to see over Miami. Very interesting photos, very interesting video. Okay, here we have the zoomed out view of this object that Jeremy captured up in the sky. Looks very interesting. And he caught this with a camera where he was able to take some very zoomed in shots, for lack of a better term, and here they are now. Now, to me, it kind of looks like there's two parts to that object, an upper part and a lower part. We look in the motion stop here, we can see it a little bit more clearly. Or is that all one object? A little bit too fuzzy to really get any clarity there to determine exactly what we're looking at. So all you armchair UFO experts out there, what are we looking at here? We've seen similar objects captured over Florida. I've had them on the program before, and some people called them balloons. Now, is this a balloon as well? Or is this a metallic object? It's really hard to tell, isn't it? But one thing for sure, I really was interested to look at this. Well done, Jeremy. Appreciate your participation on UFO Planet by contacting me with your video. Take a look at it in slow motion enhanced here. Get the best view we can. That is one wild looking object. So as far as that goes, that remains, in my mind, an unidentified flying object over Miami, Florida. I certainly can't tell you what it is. This next video, we're going to take a look at some interesting light in the sky. This was recorded on November 17th in Michigan. And this is a video that I call Sky Flashes. Now, to me, it looks a lot like sheet lightning, but it goes on forever. Let's check it out. Well, I guess we're going to need news from space. Pardon
me. T-minus 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Main engine start, ignition, and liftoff of the Atlas V with Maven. Looking for clues about the evolution of Mars through its atmosphere.
Good, still at 100% rate of thrust on the RD-180. Vehicle rates are looking good. We do have roll program in, right as expected. We are actively controlling mixture ratio. Valve position looks good. Thrust regulator valve position looks good. Speeds are good. And vehicle's operating as expected. of the range track. Everything is looking good. We're now 1.6 nautical miles in altitude. 1.1 miles downrange, traveling at a little over 1,000 miles per hour. And we have ended our roll programs. Everything is looking good, continuing at 100% thrust. And we are now passing through the sound barrier. Maven is now supersonic. RD-180 continues to operate at 100% rated thrust. We are about to pass through Max-Q. And vehicles passing through Max-Q. Rates look good. Engine continued to operate at 100%, and we have throttled down to 95% thrust, right on time. And we're now 10 nautical miles in altitude, 7.4 miles downrange, traveling at 2,200 miles per hour.
Well, it's official. Maven's on its way to Mars. A little less than a year from now, we'll start to see information pouring in from the atmosphere of that big red rock up in the sky. It's the 15th birthday of the ISS. On Tuesday, this past Tuesday, several space agencies sent out tweets every 24 hours under the hashtag #ISS15. So check that out on Twitter and see what they sent out. Now take a look at some of the photos that come from the ISS, but look at this. This was in the ESA's video on the 15 years. What on earth are those circles in the ocean? Is there anyone out there that can answer that for me? I saw that in here and I thought, wow, that's really interesting. And it's right in their 15th anniversary video. So I'd be really interested to see what everyone has to say on that. Now, I messed up there. Every once in a while, I change the order of when I show things in the program, and apparently my mind didn't click in there, so I was heading next to news from space, which would have been normal to have next. But now I'm going to go back to that sky flashes from Michigan. This time I'm going to hit the right button and we'll take a look at some sky flashes. Now, I've seen sheet lightning before, quite common here in the prairies, where just it seems like the entire sky lights up. But take a look at this. It just seems to go on and on and on there in these minuscule little flashes. The videographer put down Michigan West Metro area, so I'm not exactly sure what area of Michigan it is. It's a south-southwest sky, shot on November 17th. 23:49 p.m. Just a whole lot of light action. Has anyone seen anything like this before previously and can shed some light on what we might be looking at here? Because myself, like I said, it looks a lot like sheet lightning, but it has this strobe flashing that goes on afterwards. Is that just more small bursts of lightning that are following the larger ones? I know that happens. Sometimes in some storm areas, some storm cells, there's just wicked lightning. You kind of hope some rain comes down when that lightning's there, especially in the forests and the prairies, so it doesn't start any fires. There's the big flash. And lots of little flashes that follow up. Well, as all we're looking at is lightning, let me know in the comments section. I'll be right back after this very important message. Stay tuned.
Today I'm going to talk about Patty. Patty's best characteristics, she's stupid. Stupid and ugly. Everything she does is ugly. Watch her eat. Watch her stuff her face. Look at her. Greasy hair, dirty fingernails. It makes me want to vomit. Her dad doesn't work. They have no money. That's why she wears that nasty pink sweater. Everyone hates her, even the teachers, and they're supposed to like everyone. Get a life, Patty. Thank you.
Cyberbullying affects real lives.
Welcome back, and I just want to send out a thank you to everyone who supports the production of UFO Planet by reviewing the ads and clicking them on our website. I appreciate that very, very much. It's time now to look at a fascinating video, my most favorite video of the entire day, and this comes to us from the Bronx, New York, shot by ReptilesVid on October 22nd, and this is an amazing light show. Now, what we're going to listen to here, just in case anyone gets confused, is you're going to hear six Aussie voices, because these are six Aussies that were in New York when they happened to capture this. Pretty interesting. Have a check.
It just looks like a blurred line. It is definitely.
Oh my.
They're like in a pub.
Yeah, dude.
No, totally. I haven't. Like the formatting lines. I'll show you.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Here you go.
Okay.
Yeah. And they're pointing like really, like the lights have gone to one of them. I just wanted like there has to be.
What is it?
Well. I don't know, but like I've seen it heaps before, like lights moving in formation.
No, no, hang on a second. Hang on.
The one's dropping out down the bottom.
It's going like blue right off the top for this thing. But...
it's strange. Like, is that where the airport is? I don't even know.
What?
There's another one coming along now. Can you see it in the middle? Leaves and then one keeps coming back.
Oh my god, if they form in, I'm going to lose my mind.
It came up, it didn't put, like, it kind of came up and then its lights.
It doesn't get bright until it reaches the other one.
Yeah.
Like, you don't see a light coming along.
Oh, okay, so they go in and then come out brighter.
What seems to be happening is the bottom one always starts lowering, and as the bottom one just gets out of sight, like a new sort of light appears on the right-hand side and joins it. Like, it's happened like three times now.
It's similar to like the way a drone would look, do you know what I mean? Like a military drone or something.
It's weird, they're kind of like weird blue and red or something.
Yeah, there's another one.
See now there's another one coming in the middle.
Yeah.
And it's going to join them. And it'll get bright, like, when it gets in range of the other ones.
Wow, Kaz. Good on you for noticing.
Yeah, it's freaking me out, dude.
Whoa, here it comes.
Can you see it's going to be, like, the third
yeah, here
in
comes,
line?
Because is it just, could the light just be a proximity thing, you know? Like, is it a distance
ready?
Thing?
Ready? Now it gets brighter. Now you can see that there's four.
Yeah, I can see it.
I'm gonna Google this tomorrow. Hopefully other people have like said something about it.
But who else would be looking, you know? Like,
there's heaps of people on this one.
New York City.
Holy shit.
Well, that's kind of weird, death on that.
No, it doesn't really. It doesn't seem to be like a serious.
What?
So cool.
Yeah, they actually
Well, that's a mind bender if I've ever seen one. I'm going to disagree right away with those that are going to call that Chinese lanterns. And the reason I'm going to say that is when I was editing, it was clear that some of those objects came on up in the air. Chinese lanterns don't ignite in midstream. It's impossible. It's the lift that makes them go up. And one of those objects moved horizontally. Same thing, Chinese lanterns don't move horizontally. That's very interesting. Well, I'm already over the time limit, but we're going to go for it anyway. I have one more clip here to show you that includes around the planet from Hungary, Germany, Burbank, California, and Hickory, North Carolina. If we're going to get in trouble for going over time, let's do her good, right? First clip we're going to look at here, captured over Hungary in 2013. This one we attribute to frequency.com. Very interesting looking object up in the sky. No reference points, no movement. 2010, we're going back to Colorado, USA. Typepad.com. Very interesting looking metallic type object up in the sky there. Next, we're going to Germany. This is an interesting video. Well, it's actually three photographs, but I put it together to make it play like a video, to animate it. Check this out. That's an AWACS aircraft there you're looking at, by the way. That's the radar airplanes in the military. Now, take a look at the zoom here. It almost looks like the thing is a bug, has a lot of legs or something coming off of it. That is really wild. I don't know what's causing that, but interesting to look at over Germany. Burbank, California. Now, this is an artist's rendition of what a couple of guys saw when they were heading to the grocery store in Burbank. It's where they filmed the Tonight Show. July 1st. Hey, I just noticed that. That's a good day. Canada Day. That was probably just the Canadian military down there to scare you Californians into staying in line, or else you're going to get taken over by Canada. Hickory, North Carolina. This is one of those photos they didn't intend on capturing. Took a couple of snapshots, actually trying to take a picture of the star that you see about mid-screen there, and ended up catching this object in two photographs, and in each photograph, it's a different color. That's really interesting, isn't it? Well, that's all I have for today. Thank you to each and every one of you who have participated in today's episode of UFO Planet by sending in your videos, stories, and photos. And if you have any, don't be afraid to contact me, Darren at 4u2ctv.com. I appreciate each and every one of you taking the time out of your day to watch UFO Planet. And I'll see you again on Monday. Have a great weekend.